Hi guys, if you have seen my previous videos, then you know that I really love the Pilot watch with this dial design. Nevertheless, I had two issues with this watch. The first one was its huge crown, which I solved by replacing the crown of the watch. It wasn't very difficult after all, and there is a big variety of alternative crowns that you can choose from. But it was still impossible to find a watch case smaller than 33 mm for a watch dial of 39 mm. So I have decided to buy a new dial and to see if it is possible to resize it to 37 mm. I have already bought several watch cases with a diameter of 42 mm and thickness of 11.5 mm that can accommodate a dial of 37 mm, providing a visible dial part around 36 mm. But I also found this interesting watch case with a diameter of 41 mm and thickness of just 10.65 mm that can also accommodate a dial of 37 mm, providing a visible dial diameter of 45.5 mm. Before you do any ordering, you have to check first whether you can resize the dial without cutting the painted part of the dial. The total diameter of the dial is approximately 39 mm. So, in order to resize it to set to 37 mm, I have to cut 1 mm along its perimeter. Also, the painted part of the dial is approximately 35.5 mm, so the resized dial can be accommodated by both watch cases. On the back of the dial, I have measured gradually 1 mm along its perimeter. Generally, the main advantage that you have is that the center is clearly defined by the hole the pinion comes through. So you can also use a draftsman's divider or similar instrument with one point in the middle hole and scribe a line where you want the new dimension. I put the dial into the watch case holder. I couldn't find a better solution for holding the dial without damaging its face. Also, a good idea before you start any works is to check again the dimensions of the dial that you have marked, whether they are proper one or not. In my tools I had this file, which I thought would be appropriate for this job. And actually, if it was not my first time when I'm doing something like this, I would be much more successful. As far as I understood, it would be a better job, a better result actually of it, if I had a wider file, or if I was doing the job slower and not that fast. And if I was doing it differently, maybe. Anyhow, if you have a wider file, it will be a much better result. As you can see, you can damage the dial, the face of the dial. Also, there is possibility to find the proper angles, which would ensure that you're not going to damage the dial, the face of the dial under any conditions. Anyhow, the file should travel around the perimeter of the dial, make each pass cover about 45 to 45 degrees of the perimeter, and rotate the dial and make another pass. Then repeat, always filing, then rotating. This will reduce the possibility of removing too much of one side. Don't forget to clean the surfaces with a wind blower, as the trims can damage the dial. Also check roundness and fit often. As I have already said, if you go slowly, you will definitely have a better result than me. At some point I stopped filming and tried to do it faster, as it was getting really late and I had to go to work next morning. As a result, I scratched the dial in three places. Again, I could avoid scratching the dial by working more carefully, or if my file was wider, or if I just took better angles for the file, in which it is almost impossible to damage the dial, but in this case you will damage a bit the watch case holder, for which I actually didn't care that much. Also, you have to be careful not to damage or bend the dial feet, as you will need them afterwards when you will attach the dial to the watch movement. Anyhow, for me, the point of this project was to see whether it is possible to resize the dial. So the main conclusion of all this is that it is possible, and in reality, it is not that difficult after all. And if you have an hour to spare for the whole process, then you will probably end up with a proper result. Obviously, I'm not entirely happy with the end result, as I scratched the dial. But it happened due to my eagerness to finish faster and not taking the necessary time to do it properly. As you can see, the dial fits the case. I will tell you whether it is a perfect fit or not in my next video, where I will try to assemble the pilot watch of my dreams. I hope you liked this video, and if you found it interesting, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I wish you all the best. Bye bye for now.